moving. It's a part of being human. From the moment we're born, our parents cannot wait for us to just roll over. But the encouragement doesn't stop there. This was my first car. $300, a new transmission, and a head gasket later, and I could get anywhere in the continental United States in under 2 days. This was moving on a whole new level. But to get anywhere new, you always have to leave something behind. In this case, what I was gaining was the speed the car offered. This came at the cost of my hard-earned money, and I was emitting the pollutants that I didn't even know the name of. See, walking was simple and cheap. Walking 1 mile consumes around 80 calories of energy. That's less than a McDonald's kid's fry. Driving that same mile requires 1,000 calories of energy, 2 double cheeseburgers, and the entire kid's fries. Not only is the car much faster than walking, but more importantly, we've added 4,000 pounds of weight to our body, which also needs to be moved. You're less than 4% of the total weight that is being moved, or 96% of the energy used is moving the car. Adding people to the car, we can decrease the energy required to move a single person. 12.5 people bring us to the same energy use per person per mile as walking. A vehicle that carries more than 12.5 people is typically called a bus. However, since a bus is considerably heavier than a car, the number of people needed to be carried to equal the efficiency of walking also rises. A total of 72 people are needed to fill the bus. Once again, a bus isn't that large, so we need to go bigger. The largest American-made airliner is the Boeing 747. Fuel consumption is in the range of 5 gallons per mile, or 1 gallon a second. This sounds crazy high, but up to 500 people can fit on these planes. The energy efficiency of the airplane is 317 calories per person per mile. It would take 2,000 people being on the plane until you're as efficient as walking. There are vehicles bigger than airplanes. A typical Amtrak train uses 2.3 gallons of diesel fuel per mile. Amtrak states that the typical energy consumption per person per mile is 255 calories. This is for only 60 passengers on the entire train. A single car can hold around 90 passengers. If a 6-car train were filled to capacity, the energy use could get as low as 150 calories per person per mile. Still, the train would have to carry 1,000 people to equal the efficiency of walking. But let's get bigger yet. The Queen Mary II is the only transatlantic ocean liner left in the world. Her fuel consumption is enormous, 128 gallons per mile. But she carries 4,000 people, which means that her energy use comes in at 292 calories per person per mile. Still, she would need to carry 15,848 people to be as efficient as walking. And that's as big and as complicated as we've gotten. And yet, walking is still more efficient. Or is it? Yes, there is one machine more efficient than walking. The very first bicycle was invented in Germany in 1817. However, it was very different from the modern bicycle. You had to push yourself around by your feet. It took until 1885 until something resembling the modern bicycle was invented. It's estimated that 98% of the energy that you put into the pedals actually is used to give forward motion. Most bicycles weigh about 30 pounds, which means that 84% of the energy that I use is to propel me forward, and only 16% is to move the bicycle. What this all boils down to is that I can ride 1 mile at around 12 miles per hour and only use 53 calories.
There's like a small scoop yogurt. It's like a low-fat yogurt. It's like a go-gurt.
Go-gurt?
Yeah.
Surprisingly, the bicycle is the most efficient form of transportation that's widely available in the world today. I commute 7 miles by bicycle to work every day, and I would highly recommend it. Not only is it highly sustainable and economical and green, but it also keeps me in shape, which is cool, and then I find that gives me lots of energy for the day. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up down below. As always, subscribe. We're gonna keep discussing energy-related topics here, and that's it.